God loves Andrew Tate for these three reasons. So reason number one is that Andrew Tate speaks his mind without caring about judgment. He speaks his truth, which is what the Bible commands us to do. The number two reason God loves Andrew is because Andrew exposes the darkness of the industries and of the world and how men aren't really men anymore. And that's also in the Bible. Now, the third and possibly most controversial reason why God supports Andrew is because he used God's success formula to the T, and I'm going to prove it. So Andrew obeyed the first commandment, which is to be fruitful. That is step one. So be fruitful means to produce or to create something. The second commandment that he kept was to multiply, which is to build systems to duplicate your creation. The system he built to duplicate his creation was creating it in the form of a course that can be sold over and over and over easily without friction. The third commandment that he kept was to replenish, and that means to get the word out about your creation. That's doing features. He does a million interviews. He created affiliates. He does joint venture partnerships and everything like that to replenish the market. And the fourth commandment that he kept is to subdue the earth. It says to subdue the earth in the Bible. So this means to literally dominate your market. And as you look at him right now, you can't go anywhere without seeing his product or his name or his services. He dominates the market. So he completed God's success formula, and that's why he's successful. And you can do the same thing. Now, the business model that we use is called drop servicing. It's the same business model as Uber, Airbnb, Turo, kayak.com, those type of businesses where you promote another person's service, but you don't do any of the work, but you keep the cut. It's very simple. It's proven. Amazon does this as well. If you want to learn how to do this, you can book an appointment or go to the link in the description to start. So do not judge Andrew Tate. Before you judge Andrew Tate, remember that Moses was a murderer. Even the one that you love so much, which is Paul, he was a murderer as well, and God still used those. God is my lawyer, so this isn't hate speech. This is great speech.